How many guys notice this? So pretty nice hotel. I was supposed to do an accident. Right? Why was that? Because it was bad design. The moment you enter, I thought, it's a UNAP, it's not a site. It took some time. I don't know, someone might done an accident too. Then I came back. That's awesome, right? Why is this? Why is this? I think this is a very expensive product too. It's an important product. It's so expensive. Because it's wrong design. Wrong impedance. Okay. So he's one of my favorite designers. I think everyone knows him, right? Alright? Alright, known for long-lasting design. All his designs he has created last years. He designed logos like IBM, ABC, and multiple graphicals. Even today, the logo which IBM designed in 1960 is still relevant today, right? So what he said is, design is so simple. That's why it's so complicated. Do you guys agree with this? Do you think design is hard? Okay, so let's understand what does simple means and what is complicated means. Simple. What is simple means? Simple is nothing but point A to point B. Very straightforward, your task is done. Take an example and start. It's a button, you press this, it's so simple, that's simple. Right? Is it simple? What about complex? Complex has hierarchy and structure where multiple things are related to each other. Take an example of the car dashboard, or maybe take any dashboard which has multiple objects which are related to each other. That's complex. And what if I ask you assemble a car, not design a car? Then it becomes so complicated, which has multiple moving parts, which gets interconnected to each other separately. So, complex is the opposite of simple, and complicated is more of opposite of easy. So this is the difference between simple, complex, and stuff. And by the way, the world we live in is so complex. The world we live in is not easy, right? From day, every day morning, so we face a lot of complex situations every day in our life. The time you wake up, the time you go to sleep, you come across with various interactions, various people, various things, going to office. So a lot of the world is not simple, okay? And what do? We interact with a lot of objects every day, right? Right, toothbrush, pillow, and bed, everything. From morning to evening, we keep touching every project, and everything has a design language. Take an example of a cup or this thing. So pretty simple, right? So you have a small cup, you have a bigger cup, you have a potty pot, you have a handle. So it's pretty simple, but everything has a language. So this tells about, you can touch the particular thing, it's because of an affordance. And you have a cap, you can pose the thing. So everything, all the elements of this design are speaking something, are communicating something, right? There is a language which communicates a task or a functionality, how it's going to do it. So brands, we have multiple brands, right? So brands are always recognized by set of multiple design cues. Design cues are something like, you know, so take a design view of, do you guys remember what is this like?
Porsche.
Right? See, by looking at this just like, you could able to remember this is a Porsche light, because it's a design view. For many years, they did not change it. They maintained that particular hues in order to get their brand effect. And same with Nike, you don't need a shoe or something like that. You just look at that particular logo, right? You are actually recollect or get recognized for that brand. Same with Nivea. Right? Wherever you see is Nivea. You see Nivea logo is also like, you have a round, you have this thing, and enter all the product ranges, the brand in this particular color. And all this, the marketing material or the stalls or whatever, everything will be in that particular, they bring that particular visual cues in a way that it directly recognizes the design language of your product. Let's call that feedback. Okay? What is this? Camera, right? And what is this? Telephone and TV. So look at these, look at the language of these. So pretty cool, pretty straightforward. Camera does taking photographs. You have switch and few switches. Click on that, you're gonna take pictures. Or look at these components in terms of, you know that this is a dialer pad. Look at it, it helps to dial numbers. You have this headphone set where you're gonna talk. And same with this TV thing. So you have a channel, you have it on and off, and you have a sound button. Right? So few things, well communicated. The object, physical object from this industry, the models, communicates the design language. So let's take an example of one of the design-driven company, BMW, right? So the design keeps evolving, right, all the time. So take an example of here. So 1972, the front lipstick got designs. Even 2010, recent models, right? Look at the whole uniformity of it. All the design cues of the design language, the whole design principles. Look at that. So basically, you can relate whole products, even though it keeps evolving over a period of time, it still speaks that whole sporty philosophy of BMW. Whatever philosophy you write it for that particular design, it still continues. Even today, look at the new M2+ i3 or i9, i8. It still talks that same design language, which actually, design language creates brands. So brand identity is what actually represents the whole design language. Design language is all about a set of philosophy and set of guidelines. Okay. One more example again from industry design. Coca-Cola, recently 2016, they launched a new brand language again. The brand language is basically to unify most of their all new Coca-Cola products with the new design language across all the touch points. So recently, I think somewhere around June, July timeframe, they launched in New Mexico. So I was in Mexico City last month. I was looking at all this. I can see a lot of these sporting papers, newspapers and stuff like that. It's pretty cool. It's not just changing the sticker. The whole identity, the whole language of the whole thing, all the touch points. Let's say these are physical points, physical products, and you have digital products, right? So you have touched with all their vending machines, all their advertising things, like even the one of the parameters which also is the country, you hold that particular bottle, it talks about the holding lids, the cues and stuff. When you open the lid, the sound knob comes up, right? It's also consistent. So people should, they try very hard to make their design language in a way that, you know, it gets memorable and actually consistent across. And from India, Tata recently designed a new design language. This year they launched called Impact. So the Impact is basically more on user-centered design approach, and it's basically the philosophy of this design language is for long-lasting design. So this is the first part they launched this year, and going forward, they're going to get the same design applied, same design language applied to the other commercial vehicles. And let's go back a little bit. So previously, all the design language used to get is the famous designers. Let's go back to 1960s or something like that. So famous designers like Holland or someone else, design, whole design language, and these design language cats wins the brands. But now, brand drives design language, and design language builds brands. It's a cycle. So let's look at the components of this. So from industrial design, the components would be generally surface, material, color, function, brand, and consumer. This creates more authentic and design languages cannot be created in silos. It's not just design department who defines the design language. So it's a combination of business, design, and brand. So business includes all functions of business management, maybe engineering, all the touch points. Design is all about design, and brand is other touch points of marketing, sales, communication. So it's a combination of everything. End of the day, it's the representation of the brand. It's the interface, it's the brand. So design language should be created by a combination of all of them. And design language is multi-sensorial. It's not just visual, it's not about colors, it's not about just typography. It's all about all the multiple touch points, like smell. You have like, you know, touch, look and feel, taste, enjoy, hear. See, it's all emotion, right? So all these creates design language. So let me quickly, coming back to the latest thing. So let's look at now what's happening now. Okay, we have that camera. Everything is digital, right? Now, all the physical parts, even cards today becomes technical and digital. So phones are digital and TVs are also digital. So in the past, it used to do one function really, really, really good. Okay, cameras to do cameras, to take photos, but now it takes videos, it does a lot of other things. Same with the phone. Phone is not anymore just phone, right? It's a camera, it's a computer, whatnot. And same with TVs. TVs are also like that. So what's happening with this? So physical objects have physical affordances, right? You know, with bodily touch that. But what happens to digital UX? So digital UX language has more of these components, like, you know, visual, interaction, structure, brand, and consumer. Brand and consumer are always common because we're in the business, right? And the surface layer is more important, which actually part of visual, interaction, and structure part of it. What's happening with this? It's a physical flat screen, no importance, you don't touch it. And think about, like, you know, there are more than 5 million apps. How many of them are using it? What is happening? We are getting into complicated mode, right? Because like, and people cannot live without these devices. We are so touched with this, we are so dependent on this, and these all become part of our life. So how basically companies are solving that? How are they actually unifying their whole experience? How are they creating it? They need rules. So let's take some examples of digital UX languages, which, so Google came up with material design. Material design is the design language of Google, multiple products. So not just mobile and web, basically things and offerings are expanding, right? You know, material design guidance of Android Auto, you have the car dashboards, you have Android TV, material wearable devices. So these are set of guidance and principles of the language which Google defined for their products so that they can have those talks about them. Same with Salesforce, Steve is here. So Salesforce recently defined, came up with a new design language called Lightning Design System. It's not just about patterns. Don't think design language is all about patterns. Design language all about the interaction, behavior, touch, experience, and the whole brand and identity, the interface of the organization. Same with IBM. IBM also launched the design language this year. They call living design, living language. So the same thing again. So it's not just this thing. Even government, so UK government is more of the services side, right? So they call it as digital by default. And so even governments also use that, right? And what are we doing at Informatica? So Informatica, we are also coming up with, we have a team of researchers and designers working on our new design language. So earlier we used to just have patterns, we are defining the whole design language of Informatica. We call it as archipelago. Archipelago is nothing but a group of connected islands. So we have multiple platforms altogether, and we are in the phase of business transformation into 3.0, data 3.0, which is a data company. So we came up with a new language. So we have multiple users, right? You know, on the left hand side, what you see is we have multiple touch points, multiple users. On the right hand side is IT users, left side is more on the business users. And you have technical certification and you have structured experiences. So what happens is basically when you have more technical sophistication, you need less structured experiences. So when you find the whole philosophy about how we want to design the product philosophies for the language and with the vision. Principles plus requirements plus vision equals to direction. That's what we call it in Informatica. And we need a vision. If we don't have a vision, we don't know what we are designing for, right? So multiple designers, multiple teams working on it. So we need a vision and direction. So we created a vision, pretty defined vision, like how we want to see our products and want to define things, and came up with these design principles. So these are the six design principles: usefulness, augmented human intelligence capability, design for infinity. Design infinity is very important because, like, you know, we're an enterprise product, we need to scale thousands of applicants. So it's pretty important. And then readability, information on demand. Information on demand is like, you know, whenever you want information, we're gonna grab it. And teach through play, more on the learnability or gamification, whatever you want, right? So how we design products? The way we design products is based on that we created all those design elements. Can be multi-sensory element. So you have this, let's say you want to build something, you have many ways of already defined workflow patterns or structures. Then you keep building one by one, right? So that's how you keep building your own structure in terms of, and finally you want to build a house. Okay, you build this house. Or, but you know what? Designing this way, you are building the product, but you really don't know what context are you doing it. Without knowing the other context, just building this house, you can't create experiences. You can't be successful in creating good design. So let's put in the outer world context, right? So look at this house. It has a very cool, pretty general, concrete city general. You have a lot of these things going on. And south is paired. So you are actually creating experience when you know other stuff in terms of context of the user, context of the whole thing. Look at this. So it has a pretty nice lawn, he has a nice parking, his house is facing towards this beach, and he has his personal boat and stuff like that. And that's how I think the other experience, other elements also add to the overall experience. There are two, three things which I think, you know, which will be helpful is basically one is never design without putting user in the center, without knowing the context of the user needs. Two, when you define the design language cannot be defined in silos. It should be defined with the complete other cross-functional needs. And third one is basically when you design this whole context, validate or review those requirements. So you know that basically, okay. So if you're not designing without knowing that which side you want, how, which face you put the door, you want to put that side or this side or whatnot. So make it contextual. And lastly, make it beautiful so that no one says no, everyone wants it. Thank you guys.
the design language that you're building for your informatics? How you are resolving the challenge?
So multiple challenges, just you will encounter multiple challenges when you are actually redefining the vision for the whole company thing. The first vision is getting everyone into same lines. Got it right? So we did several workshops. So that we pulled into people, basically we brainstormed, explored various, what is the company vision? Basically, end of the day, you are working for business, you are working for users, you are working for the making money, you are in the business of making money. So finding out from like, you know, what are the sales teams, business teams objectives, what are the branding objectives, what are the engineering objectives. So we came up with the whole exercise and came up and defined those principles. And we started exploring multiple options. And one more thing is, one size will not fit everything. So we need to explore models in terms of the way you need to build it is basically it should be expandable to multiple things. Did I answer your question?
A little bit. And what is the time frame that you've sought, or you have, if you have already, you know, done the work, executed it, or started on the products? How many months or how many years did it take to get it all together?
Okay, so that's a very interesting question, actually. So this is a huge project, basically. You can't. And one more thing is, design. There is no end date for these kind of design languages, even for IBM or anyone. Design language keeps evolving all the time. That's the reason it's called living design. So it's all incremental approach. First, it takes some time. Actually, it took almost 5 to 6 months for defining the whole things, and our researchers keep working on various use cases and validating those particular things. And now we are adopting and throwing down into multiple products, and it's coming up actually. It's living, that's the thing, that it's called living design. So you keep evolving all the time. There is nothing, anything called down.